authors, it's Melody here. Welcome to Author Nation, your go-to place for everything to be a successful nonfiction author. In today's video, I want to talk about being a good guest. And part of being a good guest is preparing before the show. And that's what I want to talk about today. Something I've noticed, I've interviewed for a long time, and something I've noticed is that someone can be real genius in their topic and not necessarily be well prepared and not necessarily show up their best selves. And so we want to make sure that that genius that you have, that message, that gift you have for the audience really shines through. And I'm going to give you some ideas on how to prepare best for a show so that that happens. One of the things I suggest you do is listen to a few of the podcast episodes before you become a guest. So after they've said, yes, yes, you know, be a guest and here's all the information, go listen to some episodes. It's worth it. Do they have different segments? Is there a question the host asks over and over again? You know, just get a sense of what it's going to be like, how the interview will flow. Know your angle. Listening to the podcast and talking to the host or reading the emails will give you a sense of what angle, like how to frame your message so that it's heard by that particular audience. So plan your ideas, but don't memorize the words. We don't want you to be robotic. So just plan out the ideas, things that you want to talk about, so that when the host asks you a question, you've been thinking about it, but you're not memorized. You don't come out as a robot. It comes out natural because the interview, we want it to be a conversation. It's not a ask, answer. We want it to flow nicely. Think about your ideas. Don't memorize your words. If you're new to being a guest on podcasts or YouTube shows, practice with a friend. Just, you know, set up a Zoom with a friend somewhere else and just have them, give them a bunch of questions and have them ask. It's okay to practice. It's good to practice. It'll really help you feel more comfortable with the technology and with the situation if you're new to it. I really encourage practicing. Make sure you have the right equipment. This is going to sound strange, but a mic is the number one thing, even if it's a video. Because if I can see you, but I can't hear you, what's the point? If I can hear you, can't see you well, I'm probably going to keep listening. So I have some suggestions in the description for equipment. If you're not sure, go check them out. You don't have to break the bank, but get something that will work. And then right before the show starts, banish kids, pets, siblings, parents, partners, whoever you need to banish. Go get a drink, a cup of tea, a glass of water, something that, you know, if your throat goes raw, you can do that. And this is going to sound funny, but go to the bathroom, just like your mama told you. It's awful to feel uncomfortable during an interview. And sometimes we're so nervous, we forget those kind of obvious things. So, you know, make sure you're really comfortable. And finally, turn off anything that makes noise. Turn off your phone, turn off your tablet, shut down your email. Just turn off anything that makes noise. There's more to it. And I have a good guest guide if you'd like more. The link is in the description, but I'll leave it there for now. And I would love to hear from you. I really love your comments. So please go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know what you think. Or if you have an idea to add to the topic, please add it in the comments. I would love to hear what you think.